So before starting the data link layer, we should start by discussing about the different kind of delays in computer networks, or you can say different kinds of delays in network. This is delays in networks. Delays in networks. So the first kind of delay will be called as the transmission delay. It will be called as the transmission delay. So what is transmission delay? Assume this is one host. This is one host. This is host H1. Assume this is the second host. This is host H2. And they have a transmission media, or you can say transmission link between them. So this is the network or the transmission link, or you can say or transmission link, network or transmission link. Now this host H1 is communicating with the host H2, and for communicating, the host H1 is sending some data packets to H2. This is assume some it is a data packet. It is a data packet which may be having some bits. For example, these are the bits. Bits are 110111001 something and so on. Now the time taken to place this complete data packet on this transmission media is called as transmission delay, or you can say transmission time. So you want to place this complete data packet on this transmission media, and the data packet is 110111001, right? So this time is called as transmission delay. This time is called as transmission delay. Assume we are showing the transmission delay as TT, or you can say transmission time. So it is transmission time. Now what do you think, on what factors the transmission time is dependent? For example, this transmission time is directly proportional to the length of the data packet, or you can say size of the data packet. Okay, then what are the number of bits in the packet? Secondly, this transmission time is inversely proportional to the bandwidth of the network. It is inversely proportional to the bandwidth of the network, because if we have more bandwidth, then the transmission time will be less. If we have less bandwidth, then the transmission time will be more. So transmission time is actually dependent on the bandwidth of the network. So you can say, what is transmission time? Transmission time is length of the data packet, length of the data packet upon bandwidth of the network, upon bandwidth of the network, upon bandwidth of the network, length of the data packet upon bandwidth of the network. For example, assume that length of the data packet is 1000 bits and bandwidth of the network is 1 kilobits per second. Then what is the transmission time? Then transmission time is 1000 bits upon 1 kilobits per second. So you can clearly see, what is this? This is 1000 bits upon 1000 bits per second. So you can say multiplied by second in the numerator. So here you can clearly see bits is cancelled with bits, and 1000 is cancelled with 1000. So it is not 10,000, it is 1000. So the transmission time here in this case is 1 second. The transmission time here in this case is 1 second. In the same way, if I take one more question for this one, assume, is it visible? Right. So assume if we have the length of the data packet is 1 kilobyte. The length of the data packet is 1 kilobyte, and the bandwidth of the network is 1 kbps, and the bandwidth of the network is 1 kbps. Now remember one simple thing, the data is generally measured in the powers of 2. That means what do I mean to say here is, for example, if you have 1 byte, then 1 byte is equal to 8 bits, or you can say 2 raised to power 3 bits. If you have 1 kilobyte, then it is 2 raised to power 10 bytes, or you can say 1024 bytes. If you have 1 megabyte, then it is 2 raised to power 10 kilobyte, or 2 raised to power 20 bytes. If 1 gigabyte is 2 raised to power 10 megabytes, or 2 raised to power 20 kilobytes, or 2 raised to power 30 bytes. In the same way, 1 terabyte is 2 raised to power 10 gigabytes, 2 raised to power 20 megabytes, 2 raised to power 30 kilobytes, or 2 raised to power 40 bytes. Generally, you can see that this data is always measured in the powers of 2. But if you discuss about the bandwidth, then bandwidth is measured in the powers of 10. Bandwidth is measured in powers of 10. In powers of 10. Why I'm saying it is measured in the powers of 10? Because generally signal travels in frequencies, right? So signal travels in frequencies like this. Signal travels like this. So when signal travels like this, then if you discuss about the bandwidth, then we discuss about in 1 second, then how many oscillations are there, or you can say in 1 second, how many these amplitudes, or you can say peak amplitude in this cycle is there, right? So that is giving the bandwidth. So bandwidth is generally measured in the powers of 10, and data is measured in the powers of 2. That means if I am saying here in this case, the length of the data packet is 1 kilobyte. That means it is 2 raised to power 10 bytes, 2 raised to power 10 bytes, or you can say 2 raised to power 13 bits, or you can say 2 raised to power 13 bits, because I have converted bytes into bits. When we discuss about this bandwidth, then bandwidth is measured in the powers of 10. That means it is 10 raised to power 3 bits per second, 10 raised to power 3 bits per second. Right, so what is 10 raised to power 3? 10 raised to power 3 is basically equal to 1000, and 2 raised to power 10 is basically equal to 1024. Now, if you discuss about transmission time in this case, then transmission time here will be 2 raised to power 13 divided by 10 raised to power 3, 2 raised to power 13 divided by 10 raised to power 3, which is basically what is 2 raised to power 10? It is 1024. 2 raised to power 10 is 1024. 2 raised to power 11 is 2048. 2 raised to power 12 is 4096, and 2 raised to power 13 will be 8182, I think so, 8192. So here it will be 8192 divided by 1000, which is equal to 8.192 seconds, which is 8.192 seconds. So remember this thing, remember we are discussing about the bandwidth, then bandwidth is measured in the powers of 2, and bandwidth is measured in the powers of 10, and data is measured in the powers of 2. Okay, this is called as a transmission time. Now let us discuss about the next time, which is called as a propagation time. What is a propagation time?